Hello student, welcome to the refresher course on C programming. This time we are going to see the next concept, that is the loops. We can deal up with the loops. Let's see which are the different loops which we can use. So these are also called with the alternative name, that is iterative constructs. So the first type is the while loop. It is the entry level control loop. It means condition will be checked at the start itself. So these are some of the properties you can say for the while loop. In a while loop, the loop condition is written at the top. So that is what mentioned in this particular flowchart. Condition is checked at the start. Next, loop condition is evaluated first, and if it is true, the loop body is executed. So if this is true, then only the body of the loop will be in the execution. Now this will be continued till the satisfaction of the condition. If it fails, then directly it can be provided with the alternative way, that is to stop the code. So that is what mentioned. After the execution of the loop body, the condition in the while statement is evaluated again. This repeats until the condition becomes false. Let's see the next type of iterative construct, that is the do while. But before that, let's see the syntax, how to represent it in a syntactically. The while loop, initialization of counter variable, which will be used to count how many times the loop has to be repeated. While is the keyword which is used over here. Condition will be provided in the round bracket. Start the loop with the curly bracket. These are some of the statements along with the increment or decrement operation in the body of the loop. So this is where the completion of the loop is done. Now this is what about the while loop and its syntax. Let's look at the next type of loop, that is do while loop. As it is mentioned, do while. So here it is exactly opposite to that of the while loop. So the condition will be checked at the last and body of the loop will be in the execution. So at least one time execution of the do while loop will be done although the condition gets failed, because condition is checked at the last rather than checking at the first. So in this loop construct, the body of the loop comes first, followed by the loop condition at the end. The loop is entered into straight way, and after the first execution of the loop body, the loop condition is evaluated. So if it falls, if the condition fails, then obviously either it will be terminated or given to the other condition. So this is what about the do while. Let's see the syntax. Syntax is something similar to that of the while. Only the change is do is the additional keyword added over here after the initialization. Body of the loop is almost same. While is provided at the last along with the semicolon. So this is what the condition is as it is provided in the while loop also. And last type of the loop is nothing but the for loop. So it is also the iterative construct for the loop. So in the for loop, general format of the for loop is like this. So in a syntactical way, it can be provided like with the keyword for. In the round bracket, initialization, then semicolon, then condition, then semicolon, then increment or decrement operation. This is done by the operators also, means increment or the decrement operator. And after that, start of the loop with the curly bracket. Inside the start and end curly bracket, write down the related statements which we want to execute for certain number of counts. So this is what all about the loops and their syntax. In the next lecture, we will see the detailed programming of the loop and how to check the conditions also. So thank you everyone. Thank you very much. Practice, practice, practice.